Have you ever wanted to not just save information, but truly learn and remember it? While Notion excels at organizing and storing knowledge as an all-in-one workspace, sometimes we need tools specifically designed for learning and retaining digital information. In this video, I wanted to introduce you to Recall, a powerful tool that can act as your digital brain focused on learning, retention, and connecting ideas. Some of the key features of Recall is that you can save time summarizing your digital resources using the browser extension and the power of AI. In this case, I have this YouTube video where I've generated a summary using the extension. Next, let's edit the summary, highlight text, see timestamps, and save it to the knowledge base automatically. Once it's in the knowledge base, you can easily quiz yourself using a spaced repetition system with AI-generated or manually created questions. The quiz ensures that you really learn the material, and this is such a powerful way to retain knowledge. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. So the first step to using Recall is going to be to sign up to Recall. So you can easily do that by going to getrecall.ai and then clicking sign up. And here you can see my own Recall knowledge base. And one thing that's really useful to use alongside Recall is to get the Chrome extension. So to do that, I'll also put this in the description as well, but you can go to the Chrome extension and click add to Chrome, add extension. And now you can see that it's logged in. You can turn this on here so that you can easily click on it. So now it's pinned to my Chrome, so I can use it wherever I am. So whenever I want to save a page that I'm looking at, or even if I'm on a YouTube video, I can simply click here and easily add them in. So let's go ahead and start by going to Recall's knowledge base so that I can give you a brief overview of what everything looks like and works. So basically on the side, you can see all of your resources here that are already categorized. And you can also see recently added videos and resources here as well, including articles and anything you want to add to your knowledge base. If we go here, you can see a graph of your knowledge base and you can see how things interconnect with each other. So here I've been collecting some information about sleep, caffeine, and so on. And you can see that a lot of these intersect with each other, which is really interesting to look at and kind of click through and kind of see through what each thing is like. So you can see all of these backlinks about caffeine. And if I go back to the graph, you can see all of these here. Then there's also this section called review, and this is where you have the spaced repetition and you can add AI created questions from your digital resources that you can learn here. So this kind of ties everything together. So not only can you see the connections between each of your resources, you can also make sure to review that information and you can see everything in a handy sidebar that's already pre-categorized and linked together. Next, let's try adding a YouTube video to our knowledge base using the Chrome extension. So if we go to this video about drinking coffee, we can click the Chrome extension here and you can either generate a concise summary or a detailed summary depending on your needs. And what's really cool is that you can also edit the text here so that it's not completely generated by AI if you'd like to also take some of your own notes. And the other really cool thing is that there are timestamps here. So this is especially useful if you have really long videos. So if a video is hours long and you want to remember the content, it's so important to have these timestamps and also the ability to have AI summaries. So if we're happy with this one, we can click the plus sign here. And now if we go back to our Recall, it's going to show up in our Recall. And if we click it open, you can also see more. So again, the timestamps are still there. And if you want to link it inside here manually, you can now do that. So let's say that we want to add some links in here. And let's say that we want to link this word caffeine. So we can click this create link and you can already find it here. So as you can see, if we click here now, and it's going to load this information, caffeine, and you can go to Wikipedia to open that page and so on. So and this way you can kind of learn more information also through Wikipedia as well, depending on the words. And you can also see all of your backlinks going into this word. So anything about caffeine, you're going to see it here. And you'll also see it in the graph. So it's going to show a further connection here and how it connects to everything else. And let's say that we also want to review this information. We can click here and we go to this three dots here and click generate questions. And this is going to generate AI questions that are going to help you learn the material that's in this particular video. So now if I click review now, I can see all of the questions. So for example, this one, according to the study, how did coffee consumption affect participants' sleep? And it's going to generate all these questions. If you want to edit the questions, you can also do that through here. So if we click the three dots here, go to this gear sign here, you can actually edit the question. So if any of them are not really relevant, you can delete them so that you only have the most important questions. You can also create your questions manually as well, or even add more AI questions. So there's a lot of flexibility here. And I wanted to also show you a few other things you can do inside of a card inside of Recall. So the first thing you can see is that you can unpin or pin this card. So when it's pinned, you see that in this view, which are only your pin cards, but you can see a bigger picture by showing all cards. And the other thing you can do is share this card with others. And you can also click here to export to Markdown. And you can also click to see if there's any files attached to this card, and you can also delete it. There's also this cool button here that lets us see the connections to this particular resource, and you can also add some tags here as well. So if there's more tags you want to add, like let's say health and nutrition, you can add that here as well. And on the bottom, you'll see all of the links that are mentioned inside of here. So those are kind of some of the main components of a card inside of Recall. Let's also try adding an article to see what that looks like. So if we go to this one here, and this is about sleep as well, you can click the Chrome extension to create a detailed summary. And you can look through it here. So unlike a video, it doesn't have the timestamps, but it's still a really useful way to keep track of your digital resources. We can go ahead and click the plus sign. And if we go back and go to home, we'll now see this article here that we just added. And you can add additional links inside of here and so on so that it's really relevant. So let's say that we want to link sleep. We can do that. So we can do something like this, and you can click here to see if anything else is tagged by sleep, and then you can click more so we can see this study and you can find even more information. So in this way, you can kind of look through all of your own resources to see connections and really learn the material. So now if we go home, I just wanted to next show you a few more ways to add information to your knowledge base. So we covered how to add it through the Chrome extension. If we go here, you can see that you can add from URL, you can add an empty card, you can upload PDF, you can also import your bookmarks. And if we click plus new here, you also see the shortcut, which is Command K, which is really useful. So if we have a link to something, we can just paste them in here and it does the same thing as your Chrome extension. And if you go here, you can also do something like add an empty card. And this is where it gets really interesting because you can also add your personal notes. So let's say that you have some thoughts about caffeine. So thoughts about caffeine, and you have your own notes here about how it felt for you, your effects and so on. So this is not external resources, but just your own thoughts and ideas. And you can also add links to that. So let's say that we want to link it to the keyword here, which is caffeine. So we can link it here and we can even add tags. So this is about health. So now we can see our own thoughts here. And this can allow you to also create your own notes knowledge base, not just your digital resources. So you can combine those two in one. And another cool thing that you can do with Recall is you can even keep track of people as well. So if you want to keep track of your meetings with different people, how people interconnect with each other in your life, you can even do something really personal like that. So let's say that we have a card and you have a new contact here. You can add people here, what kind of, let's say that this person is a caffeine researcher and we want to link this to that person, you can do that as well. And you can even add a tag, which is that this is a person. So now if we go to person, you can see that new contact there. So in this way, it's really cool that you can really mold it to your own needs, and you can also use it as sort of your flashcard system. You can also see a graph of your knowledge base, kind of like you can do in Obsidian. So all of these are really cool features of what you can do with Recall. So finally, I just wanted to touch a bit on the pricing of Recall. So Recall is completely free to start using. So if I click on the pricing, you can see that Recall Lite is free forever. So if you just want to use it as your own personal notes management tool, you can use it completely for free and test it out and see how you like it. And it also does include 10 AI generated summaries, so you can also try that feature as well. And if you get the plus plan, there are unlimited AI generated summaries, priority support, and unlimited in-app knowledge cards, just like in the free plan. So I do think that it's quite reasonable. It's nice that there are no blockers on how many AI summaries you can use with the plus plan. So I think this can be a really great alternative to Notion if you're looking for purely a knowledge base that you can use with your browser extension and import all of your bookmarks and so on. If you're interested in trying Recall, who's a sponsor of today's video, be sure to check the link in the description below. I'm super excited to see how my graph and knowledge base develops as I use Recall more and more. Have you tried Recall? What are your thoughts on it? If you have any questions or comments, feel free to add them below, and I hope to see you all in the next video.